فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الإمام البخاري رحمه الله, in terms of the senate, in terms of the chain, which is one of the five conditions, is he stronger than Muslim or not? Naam. That's what's giving his book more authenticity than Muslim. So the first condition of a hadith to be sahih is mutasilul isnad, that the hadith is connected. Bukhari's ittisal is more stronger than who? Muslim. Good. How is it? If a narrator is known to do tadlis, if a narrator is safe from coming with tadlis, he's not a mudallis, he's not known to do tadlis. So he's not a mudallis. He's free from doing tadlis. Muslim says, okay, I agree with you on that one. That the narrator, I narrated my sahih, he has to be far from what? Tadlis. They both agree on that one. Bukhari then says, I will accept, because he's not known to do tadlis, this man's free from tadlis. I will accept his an'ana. He's not a mudallis. There's no place to prove that he's a mudallis. But he's narrating with an. An is what doesn't show directly if he heard it from them. For me to accept the an'ana, even though I know he's not a mudallis, but for me to accept it as Bukhari, I have another condition. It's not enough the fact that he's not just a mudallis. They have to have met each other, even if it's once. There has to be what? Thubutul liqa. I have to be able to present, I have to see that these two individuals met each other, even if it's once. Muslim, here is where he goes away from Bukhari. He says, no, they don't have to meet each other. As long as there is what? As long as there's imkaniyatul liqa, as long as it's possible they could have met, the possibility is there. Bukhari said, la, I have to know them each other. Who's stronger here now? Who's more stronger here? Muslim in his muqaddimah, he took a pen and he refuted Bukhari on this issue. The whole, his muqaddimah, Bukhari, Muslim, is refuting his own teacher. And who did the scholars say is correct in this issue? Bukhari is better. So that first condition, who do we give the upper hand to? Bukhari. وَأَصَحُ مِنْهُ. He's greater than him. Adalatu and the dabt of the narrators. Bukhari is greater. The adala of the narrators and the precision of the narrators, the integrity of the narrators and the scholars whose their memory, Bukhari handpicked the better ones than Muslim. Has Bukhari been critiqued on his narrators in his sahih? Has Bukhari been critiqued on the narrators that he's brought in his sahih? Naam. Has Muslim been critiqued in the narrators in his sahih? Naam. There are some scholars who took after Bukhari and Muslim, they checked the narrators, and they brought out some individuals in sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim, and they critiqued them. The scholars who did that is Abu Ali al-Dimashqi. Another one is Al-Imam al-Darqutni rahimahullah. La, it was Abu Mas'ud al-Dimashqi. Abu Mas'ud al-Dimashqi, not Abu Ali al-Dimashqi. Abu Mas'ud al-Dimashqi and Al-Imam al-Darqutni, and who else? And Abu Ali al-Jayani, rahimahullah. And Abu Ali al-Jayani, rahimahullah. Those three. Abu Mas'ud al-Dimashqi, Abu Ali al-Jayani, and Al-Imam al-Darqutni. Those three scholars, what they did was, they done they went into Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim, and they checked the narrators one after the other. One narrator after the other narrator after the other narrator. Today, if you come and you critique Sahih al-Bukhari, no one's going to take it from you unless you have the statement of any of those three. Because the Ummah have agreed with only these men's criticism. No one after that, Ibn Hajar, wala ghayru, could come and bring anything after these three men. Ibn Hajar, on the other hand, even defended Bukhari against these three men, let alone add anything to it. Are you with me? So if you have any criticism you want to bring to the table, you can stick with what these three men brought. لأن the Ummah قرن بعد قرن, generations after generation, they were not, no one was able to present anything after that. So the Ummah's ijma is the critique of Abu, these three scholars. And even their criticism has also been criticized. But if you do want to stick with it, you can stick with what they criticized. You with me? We don't want an Orientalist who comes today and looks at it, who doesn't even know the science of hadith at all, and just looks at it and says, it doesn't rationally make sense to me. Sah? Like, how can Nabi Musa punch an angel and the eye of the angel falls out? Okay, my brain can't accept that, he said. It's weak, the hadith. No science, no nothing. That's not what we're talking about. Or this doesn't feel right. Just doesn't feel right, so it has to be weak, even if Bukhari narrated it. Yeah? Zanadiqa, kuffar, malahida. Some who claim to be Muslims and believe in Allah, they claim Muslims. They're kuffar. They come to Sahih al-Bukhari and they try to destroy it and they try to speak against it. So here, Bukhari is what? The narrators, is he stronger than Muslim in terms of their integrity? Adalat al-ruwat? Na'am. The people who've been criticized. So when we look at what Imam al-Darqutni brought, Abu Mas'ud al-Dimashqi, Abu Ali al-Jayyani, when we look at what they brought to the table, they critiqued more narrators in Muslim than they critiqued narrators in Bukhari. Okay? I did not note it down, the number. If I'm not wrong, my memory serves me correct. Muslim has 300 and something narrators that was critiqued, and Bukhari only has 70. Bukhari is 80. Hey, you're Muslim? Yeah? 160, na'am. Say that again. Bukhari, Muslim is 160. Bukhari is how many? 80 narrators, na'am. So who has more? Muslim has more, right? And Bukhari has what? Yeah, nearly half, right? Not only that, Bukhari's 80 narrators, or the 80 narrators who've been critiqued by, from Bukhari, guess what? They are his majority of them are his teachers, his own teachers. And the man knows his teacher more than you. The individual knows his teacher more than you do. Whereas Muslim, the majority of his narrators, or the not the majority, but a lot of the narrators that are in there are what? Other narrators within the hadith. Other narrators within the chain. Does it make sense? So here's Bukhari again, taking the lead from Muslim in terms of the adal of the narrators and also the precision of the narrators. Are we all together? Also, Bukhari is greater than Muslim min haythu salamati min ash-shudud wal-illah. The ahadith which are in Bukhari have less shudud. Bukhari has less shad than an Imam Muslim. Bukhari rahimahullah. Meaning there's little ahadith which are what? That have opposition. Shudud is when there's an opposition. Bukhari's narrators have less shudud, opposition, than what Muslim has. And because of that, Bukhari then became what? And also hidden defect. The illah, Al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, of course, both of them are what? Min a'immati sana'ah. They're from the scholars of this field of hadith, no doubt. But the hadith which are ma'lulah, the hadith which have hidden defect, that are in Sahih Muslim are more than what are in Bukhari. And one thing, wallahi, you need to realize, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aba, He refused for any book to be completely 100% except His Quran. Aba. However much you're precise, however tough, you can be as, you can put every effort on the table. For you to be 100% is impossible. That's a unique characteristic of what? The Quran. وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. وَلِذَلِكَ you read your own work sometimes. You read something you wrote, a lesson that you did, or a tape that you recorded, or a video that you made. And you look back at it and you say, SubhanAllah, أَخْطَأْتُ وَأَخْطَأْتُ وَأَخْطَأْتُ. You yourself say that to yourself. Then what would others get out of you? If you think that of yourself, when you look at it and you say, SubhanAllah, I got it wrong. Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah min ulama'i hadhihi al-maydan, he's a faris al-maydan, Shaykh al-Albani. He had taraju'at, he came back on so many ahadith that he placed in silsila hadith al-da'ifa, he took from them and he put it into silsila hadith al-sahiha. Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah. Like sometimes you see some people say, al-Albani authenticated this hadith. But guess what? Shaykh Nasser came back from that authentication. Little do they know, because he's got taraju'at. He's actually come back from it. So if he believes, Shaykh Albani believes, that he's done a mistake here, and he felt that it was wrong and he came back, then what do you think about others? Because remember, when you correct yourself, it's a lot of obstacles you have to get rid of. You generally can't be biased to yourself, right? You're always on your side. You always justify your statements and you justify your positions. Whereas other people, when they look at you as a neutral ground. Does that make sense? Sometimes you get blinded to see your own faults. Emotionally, that's you, right? So what I mean by that is that Allah's book is the only one that's meant to be 100%. That's why we say that Sahih al-Bukhari asahhu kitabin ba'da kitabillah. It's the most authentic book after the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مع ذلك there are حروف, the letters and words that Bukhari has been critiqued for. Now, there are ahadith which are shad in Bukhari, and shad is from the aqsam which are mardood, and narrations which are rejected and not accepted. Sahih. So what we said was that Bukhari came first when it came authenticity over Muslim, right? So first, which one do we give? Bukhari and Muslim together first. This is the order that Al-Imam Ibn Salah and other than him have done. This is what they did. The first one is that they said, مَتَّفَقَ عَلَىٰ إِخْرَاجِهِ الْبُخَارِيُ وَمُسْلِمٌ. When it comes to authenticity, number one is what Bukhari and Muslim both agreed upon. The hadith which we call مُتَّفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ. Second one is, مَا تَفَرَّدَ الْبُخَارِيُ بِإِخْرَاجِهِ. The ahadith which Bukhari is alone in bringing it out. Only Bukhari brought it out. Then third is, مَا تَفَرَّدَ مُسْلِمُ بِإِخْرَاجِهِ. And then the third one is, what Al-Imam Muslim brought. Number four, مَا كَانَ عَلَى شَرْطَيِ الْبُخَارِيِ وَمُسْلِمِ. Number four is what? The ahadith which are what? The ahadith which are in the condition of Bukhari and Muslim. وَلَمْ يُخَرِّجَاهُ. But they never brought it in their book. So it has to be, it's their condition which they did not bring it in their books. So it's not found in their book. Five. مَا كَانَ عَلَى شَرْطِ الْبُخَارِيِّ وَلَمْ يُخَرِّجْ. Then number five is what? Whatever's according to the conditions of what? Bukhari. But he didn't bring any sahih. And number six is, مَا كَانَ عَلَى شَرْطِ مُسْلِمٍ. The hadith which are of the conditions of Imam Muslim, but he didn't bring it down in Sahih. And number seven is, مَا أَخْرَجَهُ أَصْحَابُ بَاقِ الصِّحَاحِ. All the other books which are Sahih, what they brought. Are we all together? This is the order that we bring in there. So which book do you think, guys think will go into number 7? Sunnah Abi Dawud. Sunnah Abi Dawud. Yeah, we're talking about in terms of authenticity here. You think Sahih Ibn Hibban. Yeah? Muwatta, you think, hey? Sunnah Abi Dawud. Saad, what do you think? Sunnah Abi Dawud. Hey? Sisters, what do you guys think? Anyone here? Hey, Aswad, what do you think? Yeah? Naam, Sahih Ibn Hibban is 7. 8 is who? Eight is what? Ibn Khuzaymah Sahih. Why is Ibn Khuzaymah not before Ibn Hibban when he's the teacher? And his book is more authentic. Ibn Khuzaymah's teacher, yeah. And it's more authentic, yeah. But we put Ibn Hibban first. Because Ibn Hibban's kitab is complete. Ibn Khuzaymah didn't finish his book. It's not complete. I don't know if he finished it or not, I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that. But I know the book is not complete. Sahih Ibn Khuzaymah is not complete. I'm going to mention a-turfa. A-turfa means something funny. Ibn Khuzaymah is a teacher, right? And Ibn Hibban is the student. Ibn Khuzaymah, Ibn Hibban would always take narrations from him. He would write every time. He would ask him a hadith. He would write it from him. He always had a pen and paper. And it was right next to his teacher's mouth. And he said, any time he said something, I wrote it. So one day Ibn Khuzaymah got angry. So he looked at Ibn Khuzaymah, Ibn Hibban, and he said to him, leave me alone. Why are you? Leave me alone. So he took his pen and paper and he wrote, leave me alone. Ibn Hibban, rahimahullah. This is the way and the love and the passion that he had for knowledge. It's weird that Ibn Hibban's aqidah is not 100%, but his teacher is Ibn Khuzaymah. But the Kutubu Sitta, the 6 books we call the mothers, all of those scholars, they're min aqidat Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Allah protected it from the loath of Ahl Bidah. The filthy belief of the Ahl Bidah, it didn't enter Sahih Bukhari, wala Muslim. ولا أبو داود ولا ترمذي ولا ابن ماجه ولا النسائي ولا and of course he didn't enter the Muwatta Imam Malik and Musnad Ahmad rahimahullah and Ad-Darimi's Musnad, none of that, alhamdulillah. لذلك these books are the thorn in the necks of Ahl Bidah. They don't like it. Bukhari rahimahullah put his Kitab al-Tawheed in his book. He's got Kitab al-I'tisam bil Kitab al-Sunnah in his book, in his Sahih. He's got Manaqibu, the Fada'il al-Sahaba. He speaks about Kitab al-Qadr, he has in there. Al-Bida', their beliefs, their creed, ahadiths. ولذلك, somebody who studies Bukhari and Muslim and Abi Dawood and Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah and Nasa'i and Musnad Ahmad rahimahullah and others, Aqidah will be correct. But what they did was they took these ahadith, tried to distort the meaning according to their hawa, their desires. So these are the order of the ahadith books. I mean, so the maratib and the levels that Ibn Salah and others mentioned for maratibu siha. It's called maratibu al-siha, the levels of authenticity. That's the highest level. Very good. So what's the asal that the number one is what? What was the first number one? متفق على إخراجه البخاري is more authentic than what? It's more Bukhari and Muslim, what they agree upon is more authentic than what Bukhari narrates, صح? Okay. And then Muslim. Then Muslim, right? صح? I said something before, does anyone remember? So did we say Bukhari is more authentic than Muslim? Yeah. If you guys were paying attention, I said something before. So, Sahih al-Bukhari is more authentic than Sahih Muslim. صح? Yeah? Did I say anything after that when I was speaking before? Yeah? So Bukhari is more authentic. Okay. Anything other than that? Anything else to do with authenticity? Bukhari. Huh? And also to not disconnect in your chain. Naam, so in terms of chain being connected, Bukhari is more stronger. Which comes back to the point which is authenticity. I said to you, brothers, this is alal jumla, and this is generally. There could happen sometimes, Muslim has a hadith in his sahih that's more authentic than Bukhari. It could happen. When we speak generally, we say that Bukhari is more authentic than Muslim. This is general. It's a general statement, صح? Men are stronger than women. But we do see on YouTube sometimes some woman grabbing one guy's hair. She's dragging him on the... Yeah? There's a general ruling and there's always exceptions from that general ruling. So Al-Imam Bukhari, rahimahullah, the ahadith that are in it are what? Generally speaking, they're more authentic than what's in Muslim. But sometimes we will find a hadith in Sahih Muslim due to external factors, qara'in, yuqawihi, other external factors that strengthen it, we'll say Muslim is now more authentic than Bukhari in this particular aspect. For example, a hadith that Muslim narrated by himself. Muslim narrated it by himself. Min hadith Ibn Umar. From the companion who? Ibn Umar. Which is that the Prophet ﷺ said, لا يقبل الله, Allah does not accept. صلاة بغير طهور. بغير طهور, sorry. Allah does not accept a salah with what? لا يقبل الله, Allah does not accept. صلاة, a prayer. بغير طهور. Without any tahara. وَلَا صَدَقَةً مِنْ غُلُولٍ. And Allah does not accept a sadaqah that came from stolen money. Ghulul is the money that's stolen from the spoils of war. If you take it before it's been distributed. Good. Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi in his Jami' he says, هَذَا الْحَدِيثُ أَصَحُّ شَيْءٍ فِي هَذَا الْبَابِ وَأَحْسَنُ. This hadith is the most authentic. Tirmidhi is saying this, right? Pay attention here. He's saying, هَذَا الْحَدِيثُ. This hadith. أصح شيء is the most authentic في هذا الباب in this chapter, in this particular issue. وأحسن, and it's greater. Good. But there's a hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah, which is where it's in Sahihain. It's in Bukhari and what? And Muslim. Which we took, لا يقبل الله صلاة أحدكم إذا أحدث حتى يتوضأ. Muslim shares that narration with Bukhari, but he's got his own narration here that Bukhari doesn't share with him. So the hadith of Abu Hurairah, who narrated it? Bukhari and Muslim together. Hadith Ibn Umar, who narrated it by himself? Muslim. Good. But we'll say the hadith of Ibn Umar is what? Asah. More stronger than what? More stronger than the riwayah of what? Abu Hurairah. Ma'annahu fi sahihain, even though it's in sahihain. This is the what? Asahu, the most authentic martaba that we mentioned, from the maratib that we mentioned, the levels. It's the first level. The reason is because فَقَدْ رَاوَاهُ غَيْرُ وَاحِدٍ. More than one narrated this. عَنْ سِمَّاكِ بْنُ حَرْبٍ عَنْ مُصْعَبِ بْنُ سَعْدٍ عَنْ بْنُ عُمَرٍ. Whereas حديث أبي هريرة حديث فرد is just a hadith of one person. The only person who narrated it is عبد الرزاق عن معمر عن همام بن منبه عن أبي هريرة. Whereas the hadith of Ibn Umar, more than one narrated it. But why did Bukhari then choose this narration? When Bukhari is an imam of this field, and he always wants to get the most authentic, why would he leave this narration of Muslim and actually go for another narration? Again, as I said to you before, Bukhari is observing letters and words. And he's a faqih, he's a mujtahid mutlaq. He's an unrestricted jurist. He's a faqih. He's looking for what's going to go according to his chaptering. Rahimahullahu ta'ala. So he has a word here that's in the hadith of Abu Ibn Umar in Sahih Muslim, which the Prophet says, La yaqbalullahu salatan bighayri tuhurin. He doesn't want that word, tuhurin. Muslim. Bukhari doesn't want that. The word tuhurin is not what he wants. Which is present in hadith Ibn Umar. Because the word, if you say tuhurin, it actually can show hadathul akbar. And he also shows others. Bukhari specifically wants hadathul asghar, minor impurity. That was what his fiqh was related to. So that's why he took the hadith where the Prophet said, La yaqbalullahu salata ahadikum idha ahdatha hatta yatawadda. Hatta yatawadda here specifically shows that the impurity here is what? That's minor. So he's looking at it from the angle of what? The matter of fiqh. Another thing I want to bring to your attentions, and inshallah ta'ala I'm going to conclude at that point, which is, scholars, they sometimes say muttafaqun alayhi, and sometimes they say rawahu al-Bukhari wa Muslim. So here, al-muttafaqun alayhi, are you here? And al-Bukhari al-Muslim narrated. Muttafaqun alayhi, it means that which Bukhari and Muslim agree upon ala takrijihi fi sahihayhima. So it is huwa muttafaq al-Bukhari wa Muslimun ala takrijihi fi sahihayhima, in a sahih book, min hadithi sahabiyin wahid. But both of them are narrating it from one companion. Both of them have brought it in their sahih, and they are both narrating it from one companion. Good. As for if the matter of the hadith, meaning the wording of the hadith, not the chain, but the wording of the hadith, is with one of the two, with one companion, and the other one has it with another companion, but the same matter, but each one has it with a different companion. So the lafz of the matter is the same. And of course the meaning is then the same. But the companions that they both have are different. Majority of the scholars, they refer to this one as what? Rawahu al-Bukhariyu wa Muslim. Bukhari narrated this and Muslim narrated this. That's the majority. Akhrajahu al-Bukhariyu. Some scholars are even more precise. They're daqiq. So what they do is they make it even better for you. They'll say to you, the riwayah that Bukhari narrated, they'll say to you, Rawahu al-Bukhariyu min hadith Abi Hurairah wa Muslimun min hadith Ibn Umar. They'll specify because the companions are different. We now know the long hadith of Jibreel, right? The hadith of Jibreel. We know the hadith of Jibreel, right? The long hadith of Jibreel, in the Baynama Nahnu Julusun, the Prophet came and Jibreel told the Prophet, asked questions to the Prophet. The long famous hadith of Jibreel. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated what? Who narrated Abu Huraira? Bukhari narrated Abu Huraira. Muslim narrated what? So when you come to the hadith, what do you say? Huh? So you can say Rawahu al-Bukhari wa Muslimun. Or you say Rawahu al-Bukhari min hadithi Abi Huraira wa Muslimun min hadithi Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. The ulama, they do that. Are we all together? The scholars, they do that. We'll stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.